an unusual year where we're setting two budgets at one time. Because of the 7% decrease in the year that we're in, the governor was only able to make 4% of that official. And then when we came to town, we have to finish it. And about that time, you know, the revenue slid again in December, slid again in January. So at this point, these statewide rescissions, we will open all the budgets again and then do a statewide rescission on all budgets at 7.2%. Second thing that'll have to take place then, there are four or five budgets that are extremely vital for public safety and health. And so then we're going to have to go back after making that standard revision and add back in some money to keep those budgets from having a health and safety issue. And one will be prisons. One will be forensics for the state police. There are two or three little places that will do that. That'll be the second issue. The third issue then, in order to cover what we've done, on top of the rescissions and the supplementals, we have to make the fund transfers. And we'll transfer stabilization funds from the budget stabilization account at $33 million, and then we'll transfer about $20 million from the economic improvement fund. Now that takes care of 2010. And at that point, it is whole. And then as we begin setting the 11 budgets, then that's the next issue that we'll work on. But that will be the base of every 2011 issue budget.
So you're transferring about $53 million from reserve funds.
Right.
Primarily to help keep education whole and not have any cuts in the current budget year. How much reserve would be left then for the following year, and how big would the cuts for education be then?
The reserve, there will be reserve for 2011, and I'm going to misspeak on that amount, but I can tell you from where I sit that after the 2011 budget is set, there will be nothing left. There will just be some dollars, some peanuts. And the 2011 budget will have more cuts. There'll be about 2.5% cut again. So if you look at the history, in 2009 we cut 15.9%. Now 2010 is receiving a 7.2% cut. The only exception is public schools were held harmless in both budgets because of the stimulus dollars. And of course they had their own account.
Okay, and then looking at the difference between the governor's budget that he proposed in January for 2010, for the current budget that ends in June, and the recommendations based on the lower revenue numbers set by the Economic Outlook and Revenue Assessment Committee that you guys accepted a few days ago. It looks like most of that difference is being made up through those reserve funds, and it looks like there aren't.
Now, the governor had reserve funds going into his budget when he, you know, when he formulated his budget. He also had to use reserve funds. The only difference, this is basically the governor's budget with the exception of timing. When he gave his State of the State, he said we needed another 1.6. Well, it turned out we needed a little more than that because of January's numbers and December's numbers.
And that 1.6 is the additional percentage cut.
And at that point, then as we worked with the stakeholders and the timing again, we're taking his numbers, adding what's needed to be done, and just rearranging the timing a little bit because the way K-12 is structured, with the contracts let, all of the stakeholders in that area said, backfill us for this year and we'll take the full cut in 2011, and that's what's happening.
And by timing you mean?
I mean that the cutting governor, at the time the governor spoke, we weren't sure how many of those contracts, how they could fulfill those contracts, nor did we know December's and January's numbers.
Okay, so it's holding off those reductions until the next budget.
Right, right. And you know, I can understand the stakeholders. They're going to get about a 7.5% cut. They're going to get that cut in 11, and there will be no backfill. In fact, we're taking $288 million of one-time money out of their budget. But we're backfilling with, they had stimulus money, they had about $33 million, and they had their own savings account. So they're being, I can understand why they could not get through the end of this year with those changes.
What percentage of the FY11 budget for education will be reduced compared to the original appropriation?
Well, what will happen in the FY11 budget? Well, you remember that teachers were cut at 4.3, and administrators were cut at 6.2, but then we backfilled with stimulus. So when the stimulus is gone, those will be the cuts in that section of the budget. The rest of the budget, we're going to try and make it as flexible as possible, and most of it will be in discretionary. And it appears that the discretionary money going out, with the very best efforts we can make, will be down probably 10-11%.